Okay, welcome to part two. And thank you, camera, for not beeping and letting me continue talking and talking and talking when without recording. Okay, where was I before it stopped? I was talking about grinding. We've got the lines that reduce the friction, which is really nice. And this edge of this, so I'm not a big catch zone grinder, but something really great about this yo-yo, the lip here, I don't know, it's got a sharp little groove here that I have found that it's really easy, and there's not very much actual physical space here, that contact space. And I have found that this thing, you can catch it on your finger, you can grind for a while, let it go, and just keep playing, and it will still be spinning. They really got that right. They really got this right in terms of being able to grind on the edge. What else? I just, so you know, I was talking for about 5 minutes when I didn't realize that the camera stopped. Samsung, I hate you. Anyhow, another thing about this yo-yo, I'm sorry, I was a little flustered. Another thing about this yo-yo, another sort of contradiction, like I said, I'm not talking about bad contradictions here, is it's got a huge catch zone, being an H-shaped. But it's got a very, very unforgiving string area. I've been able to get four or five reps of type 6 string in there. However, there have been a couple of times when I'm playing and I'm hitting in the catch zone and I'm thinking, all right, great, we're in the catch zone and I'm executing the trick and the string gets down into this area that sweeps down into this area, and the yo-yo is like, no, you are slightly at an angle, and I'm going to hit you in the sunglasses with it, because you got to learn how to get things straight. And that's the humor. If an object can have humor, that's how the Code 1 will laugh at you. Because if you get it, you sweep it into the catch zone, and then you're just slightly off in the... once the string's in there, it's going to hit the response, especially if you got a couple of layers, and it's just going to whackify, and it's going to whack you in the head. So either wear a helmet or be really careful about that. Let's see, what else? In terms of shape, that's pretty much it. I think I mentioned here we've got the laser engraved Code 1. And I mentioned that it comes stock with the spike side effects. I went ahead and decided to pick up a set of the lighter side effects, which are similar to the Y factor. I love my Y factor, and I think it looks cool. And so I went ahead and when I got the notice that the new side effects were out, I looked through them and I decided, hey, this thing would look awesome with a some side effects that are similar to the Y factor. So I'm gonna do a really quick little demonstration on the enormously difficult, tedious, and lengthy process of changing your side effects. So stick with me here, guys. I don't want... and girl. I don't want you to mess this up because it's so complex that I can't believe that I can do it at all. So here we go. We're gonna change some side effects. I screwed on a little bit here, as you can see, it's just insanely difficult to change over a set of side effects. Whew. I can't believe we got through that. Thank you for sticking with me. The side effects have an O-ring. This is genius design, of course. Those people who are familiar with my videos know that I'm a designer. That's what I do for a living. I do branding design and packaging design, and I used to be a metal worker, focusing on copper and steel mainly, but I can appreciate a good piece of design, and so I just replaced the side effects on the code one. It's that easy. Just for anybody new who might not be familiar with me altogether, I don't have a sense of humor. I'm not funny, but I realize it. And I don't know any jokes. I used to know one, but I don't remember it. And so, just so you know, I was actually joking when I said that it was really tedious to change a side effect. And that's because the reason why I was joking is because it's not. Now let's see if I can get the light on here to focus here. Basically, what they've got here is an O-ring, and that's what snaps in. It's a plastic O-ring. I've confirmed that it's not, its intended purpose was not to take out some of the shock, to act as sort of a shock absorber to take out any of the vibe, but it may actually do that. It might not be intended to do it, but it may do it. Let's see how long we have left here. Okay, I think we have a few minutes. So, what else? I mentioned that the code one is soda blasted, and it's got the pyromat finish that allows for really nice long grinds. I just can't say enough how fantastic it is to be able to just grind, do a grind on the edge, and then have enough momentum to just keep playing. It's just the thin nature of the material that they have here that your finger is actually coming in contact with, combined with this sharp inner lip, really, really just hits it. Okay, so what else? The code one is available for sale at Yoyo Expert. I'm sure that it's for sale at other places as well. I personally like Yoyo Expert for a couple of reasons. One is they keep things in stock, and that's important. If I see something and I want something, knowing that there's a place where it's going to be in stock is pretty important to me. And so that's one of the reasons why I recommend Yoyo Expert. Another is if you have a problem with something that you purchase there, they will take care of you. They are very customer service oriented, and that's a great thing. I know that this is ironic, being that, well, it's not ironic yet, because I didn't actually tell you what I'm about to say. It's ironic, and the reason why I'm saying it's ironic is because that I'm recommending Yoyo Expert is because all of the voting took place on the Yoyo Nation blog, and I love Yoyo Nation. I think they're great. I would love to see them. I would love to see them. I'm actually checking on the net to see what they have in stock as far as the code one. Just so you know, that's why I was saying a lot. Okay, it looks like right now they are sold out of yes, Yoyo Nation is sold out at the moment of every Onedrop Yoyo. Anyhow, I'm not gonna complain. Yoyo Nation's great. Yoyo Expert's great. The Yoyo community is one of the few communities where retailers and producers are willing to help each other out and like each other. The Woolly Markmont, for example, consider a car company deciding to go ahead with a competitor of theirs to build a better car that and slap both of their names on it. It just doesn't happen that often, but in the Yoyo community, it does happen. All right, so I think that about covers it. Again, before we stop, I want to go ahead and use my high-tech scrolling Chiron to tell you that you can find more video reviews, video unboxings, maintenance videos. I just put up a maintenance video on cleaning and looping your bearings, by the way, and other announcements up at Sniffy-Yo.blogspot.com. Sniffy-Yo.blogspot.com. Blogspot.com. Hello, George. Hello, George. I know I've gotten a bunch of email asking what's up with George. What is George? Eventually I'll answer that. But this is George. I'll answer that. In fact, by the way, anyone watching this who has sent over emails, just so you know, last week I was on vacation, and the email at Sniffy-Yo has piled up a little more than I was prepared for, and so please don't take it personally. If you sent me an email and didn't receive a reply, you will receive a reply. And I'll also, I think I'm just gonna go ahead and do a post where I'm gonna answer everybody's email all at once. But I will send you a reply. And so I appreciate all of the all the comments and all the emails people have sent in. Like I say every time I'm getting ready to finish a video, is the Yoyo community is without question.